Hi guys, and welcome back to another video. So today I've got a little bit of a different video for you, but as you can see by the title, we're going to be analysing some swimming strokes. So yeah, I am a past swimmer myself, and I thought I'd do a couple more swimming videos and look into that. So if you do enjoy this video, remember to hit that like button, and if you are new, please do subscribe, it really does help out my channel. But yeah, let's get into the video. Okay, so let's have a little look. So the first one here we have is Midnight Sun. So as you can see, we are doing front crawl here. So the swimmer here has got a nice high elbow, which is quite a nice recovery coming over the water. The elbows could be a little bit higher as they recover over. They are sinking a little bit low. But as we can see here, as he pushes off out of the wall, his head position here is quite high out of the water. So we'd like to have his head position a little bit lower to have his ear more submerged within the water. As he is compromising on his body position as he's dropping those hips down low. So he's really compromising on his streamlined body position there. So let's carry on. As you can see here, you can see his kick under the water is a little bit too deep. So he is doing quite big scissor kicks, as we call them, under the water. So he needs to have a little bit more of a shallow kick. And also, rather than kicking from his knee, he needs to be kicking from his hip. So he's got a little bit of a bend at the knee. So let's carry on. So another one to point out is his fingertip and hand position as he enters the water. So he has got nice fingertips sliding into the water, but if you look at it from front on perspective, you can see that he has been crossing over his midline of his body. So his fingertips are entering in a little bit past the midline, which then is causing a little bit of rotation with his stroke here. So you can see that a little bit more from this front on here. As that hand enters in here, it's entering a little bit past the center line, so it is causing a little bit of rotation, therefore using up more energy than is needed. So there we go, that is his stroke, but of course he does win as it is a film. And then the next one here we're moving on to is the Covenant. So as you can see, he's doing some nice dolphin kick. And then that's when it starts to go a little bit downhill. So as you can see, he is doing a butterfly in this one. His arm bend is very, very extreme, and his head position as he comes out of that water is very high. So he's really compromising on that streamlined body position. I think perhaps they use two different actors in this, as from the bird's eye perspective, the stroke looks really nice. He's got lovely undulating factor with his butterfly. But when it goes back to front on view, which we'll see after his nice push off here, back to front on, he really is raising that head really high out of the water. The chin is not even touching the surface of the water anymore. And therefore he's really having to haul his arms over. So really quite a difficult way to do butterfly, definitely making it a lot harder than needs be. So as you can see here, moving on to a front crawl race. So these two swimmers have got a nice high elbow, nice recovery over. They have got a nice pull, and as you can see, as they pull and catch that water back, they are bringing it all the way back to their hips, so they are making the most of every pull. So that is good to see. It is a sprint, so their stroke rate is pretty fast, and their breathing to the side there wasn't too bad. Their head position wasn't compromised. And moving on here, what we're going to see is a little bit of crossover again. So as you can see, the trunk and the torso having a little bit of trunk rotation. So again, that's just a little minor thing, but it's quite noticeable in here because you can see the lane line. So you can see that the body position is snaking ever so slightly from side to side. So just trying to correct that hand position ever so slightly. And then another thing to notice with this is the finish here. So as you can see with the swimmer on the right, they managed to get that touch and they managed to win that race. The swimmer on the left, kind of a very silly but an easy mistake to make, decides to take another extra stroke and then therefore is touching the wall just milliseconds afterwards. So that is another thing, just gliding out to the end is going to be a little bit more efficient, a little bit more effective than taking that extra stroke, wasting time, and then touching the wall after your opponent. So there we go, that is that one. Moving on to the falls. So if you have seen this very recent Netflix documentary, I have watched it. It's actually quite a good one if you haven't seen it. But yeah, let's have a look at Gibson, I think the character's name is. Let's look at her swim technique. So here we go. lets her dive into the pool, not too bad. We won't critique the dive for now, but as you can see, her breaststroke kick here is a very common screw kick. So a very common issue with breaststroke kick, but yeah, she does have some hip imbalances there, and therefore both sides are not really mirroring each other with that breaststroke kick. And her pool also is a very wide pool, as you've just seen. She needs to keep her elbows a little bit more tucked in and keep it a little bit more efficient. She's pulling out way too wide and pulling around a lot of the water surface. And there we go, that's doing her a little turn. And now here we're onto her front crawl technique. So as you can see, she does have a nice high elbow, a nice recovery over. She does have a little bit of a flick of the hand, which isn't necessary, but she is kind of crossing over that midline again that we talked about earlier. So she is crossing over the center line, which is causing a little bit of rotation in her hips. So just trying to control that and keep her trunk nice and controlled. As you can see here, her head position is a little bit too high. And also just want to go back here and look at the position that her hand comes into the water. So as you can see, her elbow is hitting the water and then the top of her palm is actually splashing on top. So really trying to work on the nice high elbow and the fingertips slicing in at a nice diagonal angle, rather than splashing on top of the water. So yeah, just making sure that elbow's not dropping low. So that is Gibson's stroke there, not too bad. And then here, this is another little clip from the fall as well. So just showing from a different angle that crossing over the center line there. So it's really quite noticeable from this angle. As you can see, that arm is really crossing over the left arm. It's crossing over to the right side. And then this is something interesting to note is, I think again, there's had a couple of different actors or actresses used for this shot, as this technique here is a lot better from my opinion, whether it's the camera, film, videography, or is just a different swimmer, as the body position is a lot better, the head is a lot more submerged under the water, unlike Gibson's. And also you can just notice that the fingertip entry into the water is a lot better with that nice high elbow recovery. So with her right arm, as it comes back just there, you can see that she has got a nice catch of the water, a nice feel for the water, and she is pushing that water all the way back to her hips. So she is making the full use of that stroke. However, on her left arm, as she pulls back here, as you'll just see in slow motion, she cuts it just a little bit short. So it is interesting to note just a little bit imbalances on each side, and just she's cutting that stroke a little bit short on the left side. So on to the next one is Man on Fire 4. So this is a child swimming in a swimming meet here. So I thought this was a little bit funny. For the swimming block, she is quite far back on the swimming block. You wouldn't want to be doing that, as before you've even got in the water, you're a little bit behind everybody else, but we'll carry on. So as you can see, she's gonna do a nice dive into the water. Her dive isn't so great. Her eye level should be a little bit more down with her chin more tucked, so that she's gonna be a little bit more streamlined as she powers off that block. And there you go. And as you can see, she goes a lot lower than everybody else and really has to kick up to the top quite significantly. But yeah, here we go. Here is her front crawl. So interesting to note with her front crawl, it's not too bad, quite nice high elbow, not too bad finger entry. But her breathing to the side, as you can see in this slow motion here, her eyes are actually looking up to the sky here. So she is rolling a lot, nearly onto her back. So that's a lot of time spent taking that breath, which is common with children. They do a lot of rotation, take a lot of time to take a big breath before they roll back onto their front and then carry on with the rest of the stroke. But yeah, that is something to note with this stroke, is that a little bit too much rotation. Quite a nice kick, as you just saw there. Her flutter kick was quite powerful, quite shallow, which is good. And she's just going to come into her turn here. I think we will discuss that turn another day, as a film for another day. Again, another angle just showing that over rotation as she takes a breath. It really should just be half a goggle out of the water, just enough to take that quick breath and then eyes back down to the pool floor. But yeah, carrying on here, as you can see her opponent beside her here. So it's important to notice the difference between the two swimmers' strokes. So the opponent, her stroke is a lot slower and more efficient. So she's taking a lot less strokes. So her stroke rate is a lot lower, whereas the girl in the blue swimsuit, her stroke is a lot faster. So she's using a lot more energy up. So it's not as efficient. So if it was a long distance swim, she definitely would be getting tired a lot faster. Also the opponent in the black swimsuit, her kick is a lot more shallow and she's not kicking as fast. She's still powerful, but just not as fast. So it's just important to compare the two strokes there. Yep, so as they come in here, so the opponent in the black swimsuit, she's really reaching out and really stretching out and making the most of every stroke, whereas the girl in the blue swimsuit, she's cutting her strokes short every time. So she's coming very close to her head and then really diving down with her hands. So she's got a lot of power as her fingers enter the water, and then she kind of slows that stroke down. So she gets that momentum, but then it slows down, so she loses that speed every time that her arms are pulling. Yeah, just important to notice that. Obviously, she's a child, so she is still developing and learning her stroke. But yeah, so there we go. There's the difference in the stroke. Just in a little bit of slow motion, you can see that she gets that power as she surges into the water. And I just kept this little fun bit in. As she finishes the race, she comes first, of course. But she then decides to get out of the water. As you can see, there's still swimmers still swimming in. And yeah, she runs over to her coach or her dad, not quite sure who it is. But obviously, if you are a swimmer, you don't do that in real life, otherwise you'd be disqualified if you climb out the pool before anybody else. Unless it's a really, of course. But yeah, so that's just a little bit of a comedy value that films don't take into account. But yeah, on to the next one, which is Pretty Little Liars, which is a Netflix series. Quite a chick flick girly program. But yeah, here we go. So it is a relay, front crawl relay. So as you can see, as the actor here dives into the water, I think her name is Emily in the show, her dolphin kick is very slow and quite a deep kick. As you can see, she's kicking from the knee rather than from the hip. So she's not getting that nice flexible undulation with her ankles. She's not really making the most of that. And also the streamlined isn't so great. We want to have it a lot more tucked behind the ears and a lot squeezing a lot tighter. Her arms were quite wide around her head. Her head position here is looking forward. We want to be having at a 45 degree angle, so her chin tucked a little bit more down to the pool floor, just to make sure we've got that nice streamlined position. But yeah, as you can see here again, this is the kick. So she has got a bendy knee there. You can see at the back the knees are bending a little bit too much. We want to be getting that kick propelling from the hip rather than from the knee. And this is another interesting one to look at, this snaking position that Emily has here as she's swimming her front crawl, which is due to her crossing that midline of her body again. So her fingertips are entering across, so the right arm is entering across onto the left, and then the left, and her body is snaking like this. Also, she's not got that control in her core stability to keep her nice and strong and keep her nice and stable in a nice straight line. Moving on to her fingertip entry. So it feels like she maybe doesn't have such a good feel for the water here, as her fingertips are entering, but she's not really catching the water at all. She's kind of just moving her arm back, so she's not actually really getting the feel for the water here. So they're just moving back and they're cutting really short as well. So she's only coming back to like just past her waist, and then she's ending the stroke there. So she's cutting off quite a good amount of distance every time, so she's not making the most of the distance per stroke. So here you go, you can see as the fingertips, they kind of curve into the water, a little bit of an interesting technique, and as they come back towards her hips, as you can see with her right hand here, they're not really keeping it nice and close to her hips. She's got quite a wide gap, so you want to keep it a little bit closer to your hips as you finish that stroke at the end of the hips there. But yeah, as you can see, her fingertips are pointing inwards a little bit as she pushes back, which we want to keep the fingertips pointing down so that we're really getting that catch and feel for the water as we push backwards. And there we go, that's how that race ends. She bumps her head, and yeah, there you go. I guess that sums it up for today's video. That is the end of that video. Quite dramatic, I know. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed me analysing some TV shows and movies. If you do want to see any more, there is so many more I'm sure that I can find and look into a bit of research for you guys. But yeah, I'd love to hear your feedback down below as to how you find this video. And yeah, if you are new, remember to subscribe. There'll be plenty more swimming videos coming soon. Hopefully I can get in a pool sometime soon as well and show you some technique work within a pool that you can practice at home at your local pool. So yeah, thank you guys for joining, and I will see you very, very soon. Bye.